I never thought I will say this, but previews in Xcode 15 are amazing. Till now, I avoided using previews and used the simulator or a real device whenever I could. But as of Xcode 15, I'm switching to previews, and in this video, I'll go through the 6 reasons why previews are now awesome. Let's jump right into it. So let's see the 6 awesome features of previews in Xcode 15 beta. Yes, Xcode 15 is still in beta at the time of this recording, so make sure that you install Xcode 15 beta. I do have a separate video on that. Link is in the description. So once you do install Xcode 15 beta, beta 2 in my case, you want to create a new Xcode project. So let's click on this. Let's create a new Xcode project. And basically, in my case, it could be named anything. So I will just select iOS and app, click on next here, and previews. And let's click on next over here, and let's drop it onto the desktop. I don't care about Git repository for now, because we are going to talk about the awesomeness of these previews. And let me just move the inspector out of the way there. And there we go. We are presented with the preview, which is really, really nice. Join SwiftUI Camp and embark on the transformative 4-week journey to become a SwiftUI master. Through my comprehensive curriculum, I will guide you through the intricacies of SwiftUI views, data handling, MVVM architecture, and the powerful Swift Data Framework. I will provide personalized guidance, ensuring you gain the skills needed to build exceptional iOS apps with confidence, or while constructing a practical to-do app. Don't miss this opportunity to unlock your full potential in SwiftUI and elevate your development career. Enroll in SwiftUI Camp now and embrace the future of iOS app development. An early bird discount of 50% off is available for those who act now. The link is in the description. So, first thing that you notice with Xcode 15 is this new preview macro, which is much more simpler than the previous setup for our previews. And one awesome thing that we can add in here is just have a name for our preview, and we just add it just like that. And as you can see now, here it has been updated. Now, previews are really awesome because we can just update on the fly. As you can see, hello content view. It's that amazing. Now, the second one that I really, really enjoy is live mode. So right over here, if I just add, this has been already selected. So by default, live mode is enabled on the preview. So if I add a button right over here, and let's just say tap me, and I don't care about the action for now. As you can see, I can interact with it. I can navigate, I can do all sorts of things, what I would do when I'm testing my app. So now you can test inside the canvas, inside the preview. By the way, just a heads up, if you don't know or you don't have the canvas enabled, you won't see the previews. Make sure that you enable it right over here. And also make sure that you do have a preview, because even if it's the canvas is enabled and you don't have a preview, then you won't see this, of course. Now, second one is the selectable preview. And this is the second icon right over here. Now, this isn't live, it's not interactive. So you can just select any of the elements. And as you can see, it is nicely highlighted. It's really, really nice. Now, maybe you want to change the globe. So you just double click. And in these particular text-based views, you can double-click on it and it will highlight it. And maybe I would just go and add in house right over there. Okay, so now, and the same goes for the Hello Content view. Also, really nice feature that you can just have the inspector right over here and maybe just add some paddings over there. So we're going to have a vertical padding on the text. So as you can see, the code has been automatically added. And you know, on the inspector, you will have many, many options according to the view that you have selected. So selectable previews are really, really great. Now, let's talk about variants. And this is the third icon right over here. Let me just remove the inspector and go right over here. You will see that we have color scheme variants, orientation variants, and you can't really see it because it's cut off, but we have dynamic type variants. So let's talk about all of these three. And the easiest way of doing it is to just have a color scheme variant. There we go. Now we can see the light appearance and the dark appearance, which is really, really nice. So next up is the orientation variant. So portrait, landscape left, landscape right. Of course, you can zoom into this, you know, because we are really, really zoomed out. You can't really see the details over here. And finally, we have the dynamic type variants. So extra small, small, medium, and you know, you just zoom, scroll all the way down to AX5. So really, really nice. As you can see, this has to be addressed when you are building your apps. Finally, we have device settings. So it's right over here. And if you choose to enable color scheme, then you can have, you can take a look at the dark appearance or just switch it back to a light appearance. As you can see, it's really, really nice. Also, you can set up the orientation. So let's enable that. And now all of them are landscape left, or we could just go landscape right, why not? Or just set it back to the default portrait. It's really, really nice. Now, if you disable any of these, then the default values will apply. Okay, next up is the preview device, which is really, really nice. So as you can see, currently it's set to automatic. And if you click on here, you will see that we have the recent ones, iPhone 14 Pro, iPhone SE, or you can select one of the predefined devices that have certain characteristics. So for example, we have a dynamic island, Touch ID, iPad 12.9 inch, and the iPad mini. Also, we have here a more. So if none of the default values are great for you, you can select any of these. And then if you plug in your phone, your actual device, and if this device is running iOS 17, then you can preview your work on the device. So this is what I'm going to show you right now. Let's just select this. I want to make sure that you open up your phone right over here. So let's take a look at my iPhone. I have already set up QuickTime Player. So here it is. We have Hello Content View. We can also tap over here. It's really, really nice. Now, the good part here is that this is running on an actual device. And if I change some things right over here, it will automatically be updated on the device. As you can see, it's just hello there in a fraction of a second. But most probably, this will make your development life much, much easier. You will debug your views much, much faster. Now, I really do like this image system named house, but if you want to take a look at animating these SF symbols with SF symbols 5, make sure to check out this video right over here.